trying to divide the nation into two teams, the political team and the local team, whereby the political team, they are trying their best to fight the unplanned demonstrations on 8th. But before you continue, let me assure you that this 8th of August should be our day to reclaim back the government of Kenya into the safe hands. Okay. Kitu inajaribu kufanywa hapa, wanajaribu kutuchezea mind game wakisema ya kwamba huo kashakuwa impeachment plan, huo President Ruto's reception, huko coast, whatever, Cleophas, Malala, whatever. All this they are trying to do, hii ni game tu yenye wamepanga, whereby if they win this game, either way, even the culprit who will be impeached will still benefit from that winning. But the common mwananchi will not benefit anything. So what I want to urge you, my fellow, is that wacha tuendele, our aim, let's not be swayed and be divided on political basis and tribal basis. And this is what the leaders are trying to their best level to ensure that they divide the nation on tribal basis. Because they don't, once they divide the people on tribal basis, they won't unite and fight against the economic crisis that we are facing at the moment. So what I want to urge you is that on that day, acha tujitokeleze with the same hunger that we are having at the moment. Acha tujitokeleze kwa street, tusifike kwa street tujikute tuko watu watano, watu kumi, hapana. Hizo namba, tumeona inji kadhaa such demonstrations and they work. My friends, on that day, mtu asikae kwa nyumba, waje utokeleze, hata kama wewe, utakuwa mbele, tutakuwa wengi, yes, kama utakuwa mbele, wewe penye utakuwa tu, na tusiwe specific that we are going on a certain street, no. Once we unite and have that numbers, men as we are expecting, is the time we will march to a common destination. But at the beginning of the day, wacha mtu atekeleze mali yako na hiyo ana usipepe silaha na flag yako, maji yako na simu yako kurecord events zenyewe wewe mwenyewe unajisikia. Tumetishwa vya kutosha, tunaanza kuambiwa mpaka about shut some medias, whatever. Okay, this kind of ruthless is what we are trying to eliminate in this nation and that is what we are fighting for. So try to educate your neighbor, try to educate your parents, try to educate whoever is next to you and you feel like he can give you a company on that very day. Thank you so much.
Asante sana, Victor. And guys, amina nataka kuuliza swali. After all these happenings that have been happening in our country, does this mean that our parliament is incompetent? Do we have an incompetent parliament? Do we have an incompetent government? Because value-added tax on fuel was also declared unconstitutional. Housing levy was declared unconstitutional. Finance Act 2023 is now declared unconstitutional. SHIF, whatever that is, it was declared unconstitutional. Finance Bill 2024 was also deleted altogether. So does that mean, this is a question to you, does that mean that the government, the current regime is all incompetent? They pass punitive laws that don't work. They have ideas that do not work. Does it mean that they're incompetent? George Ndegwa, good morning. Talk to us.
Good morning. Can you hear me?
When you come on the mic, just talk. Don't ask if you can hear. If you can't hear you, we will tell you we can't hear you. So, nini unawawestia two time. Wana kusikia? Kama usikiki, tunawashio tu. Aya, talk to us.
Good morning to you all. Mine is just to synthesize the people because my worry is that if we fail on it, we all fail. And my real point is, if we all agree and we sensitize people to come out, a million numbers, mtu akuwe na watu kama watano, kila mtu akuwe na watu watano, na watokee, na tutoke Nairobi kwa njia zote. Watu watongeta Langata Road, watu waingilie Mombasa Road, watu wa Jogoo Road watoke, tukuje Tao sisi wote. The police will have nothing to show up. Watakosa watu wa kushoot. Watakosa watu wa kupiga. Watapiga tear gas kama siku ya 25th, watachoka. That is one thing ambapo mimi na insensitize sana. Watu, kila mtu penye yako, ukienda pahali hata watu wakiongea waambie tarehe 8. Na siuseme ati moto, watu watoke. Kazi zifunguliwe siku hiyo. That is the one thing that I really insist. Hata penye mimi naenda kila mtu namwambia on 8 nataka kukuona kwa barabara, because if we fail here we are all done. Because if you look at the government how it's doing right now, they even don't care what you're doing. The finance bill of 2023 yesterday was unconstitutional. Look at the parliament now. It's just now doing the Lord's work, coming to clean up the mess that it was there. They have done nothing. They cannot go back to tell now, come and say, because now the 2023 bill was constitutional, we have to refund all the money that was collected. They cannot do that because they don't care about Kenyans. They are there because of their tumbocrats. And secondly, the issue of Ruto and Raila is becoming unbearable to Kenyans. If you ask everyone everywhere, kila mtu amechoka kuhusu wazee. And unajua, for me, I've been following up Raila for some times, and I can see for him to do whatever he has done to go to Ruto, anataka kuonyesha wa Kenya kuwa ati yeye anaweza fanya kitu na kuna kitu mtafanya Ruto. Kenyans need to get out na wamuonyeshe he is out of bound, na yeye amekuwa mzee atoke kabisa. Because for me, I feel he's a letdown. If you look at now, Junet yesterday was saying they are going to take the PS positions, they are going to take all the vacancies that are in the government. That is to say now, they have gone to the bed with the government. There's no one to come and rescue us from this regime. The parliament is down. The executive is down. Where are we? So for me, mimi ile kitu nasema tu, na naombea tu, kila mtu penye yako, waambie watu watoke. Watu wako FB, waambie watu. Watu wako TikTok. Hiyo tu, from now, we have only now 7 days to go. Time is running out. And if you don't get out there, now because if we become few on that day, it will be a mass massacre for the police, because washajua ile kitu mnapanga. Lakini watu wakitokea wengi, a million plus, hakuna kitu hiyo watu watafanya. That's my submission for now. And thank you for giving me the mic for today.
Asante sana.